Hi everybody, a pretty incredible day today, so I just want to give a quick video of the turtle shell because the stuff I took on my other camera isn't uploading because I'm having an issue with my main computer. So this is the way I got it home. Luckily enough, there was a giant rainstorm and I had to drive about 15 miles an hour all the way home, avoiding flooding and cars stalled out and lightning crashing all around. It was insane. Robert, good call on getting the hell out of there. You had some kind of sixth sense because about 20 minutes after you left, lightning started crashing all around and I got the thing cleaned up. And here's my gloves. Everything's just like I left the site. I put this in my front seat and got it stabilized. And wow, it is amazing. So you can see the edge of the shell. It's upside down right now. The shell goes underneath and it's supported by sand. And all the pieces are here. Over here, these, I know where they go. They're at the bottom of the shell on the right side or whatever side. It's hard to tell. My brain's a little mushy right now because it was pretty fun today. So the big thing is inside this oil here. And that's the star polyp point that I found the base today. It's in there. I'm just going to let it soak. I want to get it out and let it dry out, get it glued back together. But I might not glue it back together. I might just leave it and just put it in a case just like it is. That's amazing. That's really hard to find, usually tips and stuff like that. But this place so far has gotten three. This is the third one. So the turtle needs to be preserved. But over here is, hang on a second. This is the tip section. So whenever I get a base, I come back here and I look at the tips. Look at this tip right here. This thing, I've shown it before on other videos, but man, I love this thing. It is like greasy agate. It's still got some oil on it, but it's that greasy stuff. I found it at Oldsmar before. And just look at the thin, I mean, it is just, it's hard to describe how thin some of these are. This one right here, this is, if you were to measure this thing, that has got to be, it's like an eighth of an inch, and that is a razor tip to something. And I'm waiting to hopefully find, where is it, hang on, bear with me here. I'm kind of stunned, and I think there's more stunning things to come. There they are. Okay, see this one? This had this blotchy red on it. And that thing is missing a little piece in the middle. And this one right here, I'm not sure about this one, but it really looks interesting. So today was pretty amazing. Zach, great to meet you. Robert, thank you for introducing me to Zach. Philip, man, you just jammed. You know, Philip, I gotta hand it to you. You were quiet and you sat in that hole and you sifted and you did what you had to do to find that stuff. And it is hard, man. You saw how hard that is. So anyway, great job, everybody. And there's gonna be much more videos to come. Anyone who wants to see pictures of the finds, it's on Instagram and it's called The Void of Er, E-R. And there's a underscore in between each word. So the underscore void underscore of underscore Er. I'll probably change that at some point to St. Petersburg Artifact Recovery. But right now, The Void of Er is where it's at right now. So here's a little thing that I got the other day. I glued it back together. I tried to find as many pieces as I could of it while I found it. But there's some that were just, it was too late. But this is a handle to one of these. You see how these points here have these bases like that? Well, this has two grooves on either side. And I had this confirmed by Bob Austin, looked at it. And, I mean, he was pretty, he's like, well, look at the grooves. And look at the length of it. And it's just a perfect handle, man. This was a big, giant blade inside of this thing like that. So this site is really incredible. I'm doing my best to try and possibly safeguard it. And that's it. So there'll be more updates as we go along. There's been a change of plans, and tomorrow I'm going back to the site. So I'm going to probably do most filming with my phone right now until I get the GoPro 7 that's coming in just probably a couple weeks. So anyway, I'll give you a tour here of some glasses I'm working on. These are Trimes. Let's see if I can get the Trime in there. It's hard to see. Anyway, Trimes. This is a bottle from Denison, Iowa. And that's all the St. Pete's that I'm working on. I do them in phases. So anyway, that's it for now. And I will be updating, obviously, on the turtle shell and progress of that. So the next step for this thing will be to... I really want to get some really clean water with no chlorine or anything in it. I have filters for my garden that take chlorine and all heavy metals and stuff like that out of it. So I'm going to take this and lift it up really carefully and get it in water and see if I can just gently go back and forth and get the sand to come out of it. I might actually, while it's sitting like this, scoop as much sand out of it as I can. But see, the bones of this turtle are intact inside the body here. I was really hoping there was a giant 6-inch point in the middle that some person was crazy and just said, I'm going to bury this thing in there. But that was obviously fantasy. There's roots still stuck in there. So we did a good job getting this out fairly quickly. And we'll preserve this and then we'll get pictures of that. Okay, that's it for now. And I'll see you next time.